Hello, my name is Joshua Brown from the interview training company howtobecome.com, and in this presentation I will teach you how to pass your executive manager interview. So if you have an executive manager interview coming up for any organization, then please make sure you watch this video from start to finish, because I'm going to help you to stand out and succeed. To achieve that goal, this is what I'll cover. I'll start off by giving you a list of executive manager interview questions that I strongly recommend you prepare for. I'll also provide you with example high scoring answers to those questions to help you to succeed. Plus, I'll make sure to give you some essential tips for passing your executive manager interview before finally telling you how you can instantly download these slides plus 21 great answers to executive manager interview questions in a PDF guide. And just very quickly, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because I want to help you to pass your interview by giving you brilliant answers to the toughest executive manager interview questions. And I can only do that if you are subscribed. Please don't forget to hit that like button, because this tells me you find these tutorials useful. Okay, let's take a look at that first executive manager interview question, which is, tell me about yourself. Now, this is a brilliant opportunity to get your interview off to a flying start and impress the hiring manager. You can be the standout candidate by focusing your answer on the following things. Number one, the skills and qualities that you have. Do not talk about your home life or your personal life unless it's relevant to the job role itself. Instead, focus on your experience and your passion for working in the role. Again, make sure that experience is relevant to the job role. And also, make sure you also tell them how you're going to add value to their company. A great way to do all of these things is to study that job description in detail and focus on telling the hiring manager or the interview panel how your skills are a perfect match for those that they desire, for those skills that they list on that job description. So for example, if on the job description it states they're seeking someone who is analytical with great communication and leadership abilities, then throughout your executive manager interview answers, be sure to use those exact terms and back it up with evidence. So let's take a look at a top scoring answer to help you. Tell me about yourself. Thank you for inviting me to be interviewed for this executive manager position today. I bring over 15 years of experience in the tech industry, with a focus on driving innovation and leading high-performing teams. I hold an MBA from Stanford and a bachelor's in computer science. My journey began as a software developer, which gave me a strong foundation in problem-solving and technical skills. I transitioned into management and have since led initiatives that resulted in a 30% increase in revenue and a 25% reduction in operational costs. My leadership style is collaborative. I believe in empowering my team to make decisions while providing strategic oversight. I'm particularly passionate about leveraging technology to solve real-world challenges, and I'm always on the lookout for the next big opportunity. I'm excited about the prospect of bringing my unique blend of skills and experience to your esteemed organization. Wow, what a powerful way to kickstart your interview and be that standout candidate. Remember, by giving a confident answer like this to that opening interview question, not only will you impress the hiring manager, but you'll also gain confidence in the rest of your answers to come. Okay, let's take a look at the next executive manager interview question, which is, what do you want to achieve in your first 90 days as a leader? Tip number one. Be specific and measurable. Clearly outline specific goals and the steps you plan to take to achieve them, ensuring that your objectives are measurable and aligned with the company's overall strategy and mission. Tip number two, demonstrate value and impact. Focus on actions and initiatives that will have a significant positive impact on the team and the company, showing how your leadership will bring value and drive results from the onset. Let's take a look at a brilliant top scoring answer to help you. What do you want to achieve in your first 90 days as a leader? In my first 30 days, I plan to conduct a comprehensive assessment of the team, the processes, and the key performance indicators. This will involve one-on-one meetings with team members and stakeholders to understand their perspectives and challenges. By day 60, I aim to identify areas for improvement and present a strategic roadmap to the executive team. This will include quick wins and long-term goals that align with the company's vision. By day 90, I intend to implement the first phase of this roadmap. This will likely involve streamlining processes, initiating key collaborations, and possibly reorganizing the team to better align skill sets with objectives. Throughout this period, I'll maintain open communication channels to ensure everyone is aligned and engaged. My ultimate goal is to create a high-performing, agile team that not only meets but exceeds expectations. Okay, don't go anywhere, as I still have more interview questions and answers to give you. But when you're ready, please click that link in the top right hand corner if you want to. It will take you through to my website, howtobecome.com, where you can download my 21 executive manager interview questions and answers for all organizations to give you the edge in your interview, including the ones that we're covering right now. Okay, here is the next executive manager interview question. What metrics do you consider the most important when evaluating performance? Tip number one, prioritize balanced and relevant metrics. This is really simple, but so important. You must choose a balanced mix of quantitative and qualitative metrics that are the most relevant to this role that you are applying for and the company's goals, demonstrating your understanding of the multifaceted nature of performance evaluation. And tip number two, relate the metrics to business outcomes. Clearly relate your chosen metrics to tangible business outcomes, showing how they can effectively measure individual, team, and organizational success and contribute to the company's overall objectives. Let's take a look at a brilliant top scoring answer to help you. What metrics do you consider the most important when evaluating performance? In my experience, performance evaluation should be a multi-dimensional exercise. Financial metrics like revenue growth, profit margins, and return on investment are undoubtedly crucial, but they are end results that are influenced by various factors. I also prioritize operational metrics, such as employee productivity, customer satisfaction scores, and process efficiency. These provide insights into the day-to-day functioning of the team and can be early indicators of financial performance. Additionally, I look at innovation metrics, like the number of new products launched or process improvements made, as they reflect the team's adaptability and forward thinking. Lastly, but equally important, are cultural metrics, like employee engagement and turnover rates. A high-performing, motivated team is often the differentiator between good and great performance. By balancing these diverse metrics, I aim to create a holistic view of performance that aligns with both short-term objectives and long-term strategic goals. Okay, let's take a look at another executive manager interview question. This time it's, describe a time when you motivated your staff. Tip number one, be specific and outcome focused. Detail a specific instance where your motivational strategies led to enhanced team morale and productivity, and describe the positive outcomes that resulted from it. And tip number two, highlight empathy and understanding. Demonstrate how you used empathy and an understanding of your team members' needs and their motivations to create an encouraging and supportive environment, fostering a sense of unity and shared purpose. Here is a great top-scoring answer to help you. Describe a time when you motivated your staff. In my previous role as Director of Operations, I noticed that our team's productivity had plateaued, impacting our quarterly targets. I realized that the team was disengaged, so I initiated a hack week. The concept was simple. Team members could work on any project that interested them, as long as it had the potential to benefit the company. I also introduced a small incentive, a prize for the most innovative project. The results were astonishing. Not only did we see a 20% increase in productivity, but two of the projects developed during that week were later implemented, saving the company over $100,000 annually. More importantly, the team morale skyrocketed. They felt empowered, valued, and motivated to contribute their best. This experience taught me the power of intrinsic motivation and the importance of creating an environment where employees felt invested in the company's success. Okay, let's take a look at another executive manager interview question that you should prepare for. Why do you want to be an executive manager in our company? This interview question is a tough one. It's designed to weed out those who are applying en masse to all companies. Instead, the hiring managers want to find those that truly respect and have a desire to work for their company. So you must demonstrate your passion for their organization, show that you understand their brand and their reputation, and also show that you have a commitment to wanting to work for them for the long term. That is really important because they don't want to spend time, money, and resources in the hiring and training you up for you to only decide the role's not for you after a few months and they have to go through that entire process yet again. So say you want to work for them for the long term. Here is a great top scoring answer to help you. Why do you want to be an executive manager in our company? I've been following your company's growth and innovation for years, and I'm particularly impressed by your commitment to sustainability and community engagement. These values resonate deeply with me. As an executive manager, I see an opportunity to contribute my skills in strategic planning and team leadership to further elevate your brand and impact. Your company is at an exciting juncture, poised for expansion, but also facing challenges that come with scaling. My experience in successfully navigating similar growth phases With my experience in successfully navigating similar growth phases, I believe I can bring valuable insights and strategies to the table. Additionally, your focus on cutting-edge technology aligns with my passion for leveraging tech solutions to solve complex business problems. I'm excited about the prospect of leading a talented team to drive sustainable growth while also making a meaningful contribution to society. Okay, now if you want to get the full list of 21 executive manager interview questions, and if you want to accelerate your learning even further to pass your interview at the first attempt, is to click that link right now in the top right hand corner of this video for two reasons. The first reason is it will take you through to my website, howtobecome.com, where you can get all of these answers we just covered, plus a total of 21 brilliant responses to executive manager interview questions. And secondly, the next reason is I've given you three smart questions to ask at the end of your executive manager interview on that page. It's a brilliant resource, guaranteed to help you prepare effectively for your interview and also, more importantly, put you ahead of the competition. Make sure you check out that link. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Please don't forget to subscribe, as I'm on a mission to help as many people as possible pass their job interviews, and I can only do that if you are subscribed. Please also hit that like button, as that encourages me to make more videos just like these. And if you have any questions regarding any job interview, do let me know in the comment section below so I can get back to you with even more interview tips and advice. Oh, and don't forget to connect with me on LinkedIn. I've put my LinkedIn link in the description below. It's always great to connect with like-minded professionals such as yourself. Thank you so much for watching. I wish you all the best for your interview. Have a great day.